guys, how's it going? So a few days ago on Instagram, I posted on my story being like, hey, ask me some questions and I will answer them in a YouTube video. So basically, I just took a bunch of screenshots of the questions that you guys asked me and I'm just gonna answer them. So yeah, I hope that you guys enjoy this video. Okay, so question number one is, what is your job? So I have been working at the same place for 6 years. I work in a retail store called Shoppers Drug Mart. It's in Canada, just kind of your basic like drugstore, pharmacy slash other, you know, stuff. So some of the things I do there is be a cashier, a post office clerk, a merchandiser, a supervisor, a manager type person. I'm basically everywhere. So I do work full time, just over 40 hours a week typically, and I really, really like it there. Although there are some stressful times, but where is there not? It's mostly pretty good. Question number two, do you like metalcore slash deathcore? So I'm honestly like really bad at like genres of music. Like I do like darker and like heavier music and stuff, but I'm not sure. I feel like there's so many different variations of like metal and stuff and I really don't know the difference. I would say definitely like I totally like that kind of stuff. Like you could put on like the heaviest music and I would dig it, but I don't necessarily like listen to it. I'm very exclusive in the type of music I listen to. Like there's probably about like under 10 bands that I'll just cycle through, going through like mad phases of like certain music and stuff, but like my main ones that like I cycle through are like Bring Me the Horizon, Falling in Reverse, Escape the Fate, Ghost Town, The Pretty Reckless, that type of stuff. And then I also like Headley, Mariana Trench a little bit. I had a huge thing with Mariana Trench a long time ago. Don't listen to them as much now, but I still obviously like their music. I really like Lights and Evanescence, and I don't know, there's just like certain music that I really enjoy listening to exclusively that, but that doesn't mean I don't like metalcore and death metal music, whatever, all that type of stuff. That kind of answers the question. I just don't know a lot of bands and I don't have the time to fully invest into learning about new bands and all of their songs because I'm just so devoted to the music that I do listen to that I'm like, I don't got time. Question number three, what is your battle tag? So I give this out quite frequently on my Instagram and stuff. Like if anyone asks, I'm not scared to share it. So feel free to add me. My battle tag is Lady Sylvanas number 1598. Sure, anyways, I will verify that information and make sure that those are the right numbers. Question number four, what do you want for Christmas? So this is kind of an obvious answer, but no one's gonna actually do it, but I would love to just get like tattoos for Christmas. Like if my family could just come together and be like, hey, here's like $500, go get a tattoo. That would be like my dream thing, but that's not gonna happen. So other than that, I don't really care what I'm gonna get. Like for the most part, my family and stuff won't buy me things that I actually want, because the only things that I want are like World of Warcraft related things, and like you have to order most of that online. So like, I mean, I'm probably just gonna get like clothes or like gift cards or something like that, and I mean, that's fine. So, question number five, how your love started for WoW and when? So I've been playing World of Warcraft for like over 12 years. I keep thinking it's only 10, but it's totally been longer because I was like 9 years old and I was definitely there during vanilla. So it's been a really long time. Another factor though, because I was so young during vanilla, I basically didn't really do anything. Like I never raided or anything. I barely even quested. I just wanted to run around and like try to go in places that you weren't supposed to go. Like I remember like always being on YouTube, like how to get on top of Ironforge, or like the highest point you can jump from and use slow fall. Like I was all about that type of stuff. Like I didn't really care about actually like playing the game. I just like to run around like an idiot, but I was there. And I know I was there because one, my brother and I played together, but two, I remember being so excited for months for Burning Crusade to come out. But it's just really hard thinking back because it's like I was so young and I can't believe I was actually there for all that, but I was. I've always like loved the game, but I would say like when it got like really real to me and like really intense, say it was like halfway into Wrath of the Lich King and into Cataclysm that I was like really fully into it. And the reason why mainly was because I was dating a guy at the time who also played World of Warcraft, and it was like one of my only past relationships where like it actually, I don't look back and be like, oh my god, that ex sucked. Like I actually had a good time playing World of Warcraft with this guy, and like we played all the time, and like I ended up like moving away and like hours away, and we still played like long distance for like a year or two, and like I feel like that was when I was like, I love this game, because that was really the only time I had someone to play with who was actually just as into it as I was. So that around that point was when I really started to like care a whole lot about it, and I met some people at high school. Like when I moved a few hours away from my ex-boyfriend, I met a few people who also played, and I kind of played with them. You know, things were just so good back then. And then even when I did break up with that guy, like I was just, from playing so much with him, that was when I was like, okay, this game is everything. And it also helped me through being like bullied and literally having no friends. And I just kind of embraced the whole having no friends thing. And I'm like, I want to be known as the weirdo who plays World of Warcraft and is obsessed with it. So during my high school years, during lunchtime, I literally used to just sit down in the hall and read World of Warcraft books. And I would have some people try to like talk to me and be my friend, and I would just kind of be like, I just want to read my WoW books, leave me alone. So I was extremely like antisocial, just the World of Warcraft weirdo. So I would say like I've always loved World of Warcraft for like the 12-13 years that I've played, but it really peaked for me around like Wrath of the Lich King, Kata. That's when I was like, oh damn. And around that time I was starting my YouTube channel, so everything's just kind of blossomed from that point. I absolutely love World of Warcraft so much. Question number 6, do you play any other games besides WoW? Well, not really. I have played quite a few other games, but nothing is as prominent in my life as World of Warcraft. I did have a bit where I was extremely into Heroes of the Storm, like more so than WoW for like a good year. It was kind of my prioritized game, and I do still absolutely love Heroes of the Storm, but ever since Battle for Azeroth came out, I have been back into my WoW love. So Heroes of the Storm and WoW are my main two. I've also played Diablo, a lot of like the Tomb Raider games on like Xbox/PS4, but I played it on Xbox and stuff. Neopets the Darkest Fairy was a really big thing for me when I was younger, as well as just Neopets as a whole was like a big thing. I've played a few like Lord of the Rings like games like on the PS2 and everything. I don't know, I feel like there's just a lot of like random stuff, but I've never really like been into it the way I was with World of Warcraft or anything. But Neopets the Darkest Fairy is probably like my most played through game. Like I've beaten that probably 8 times and I love that, and that was my childhood. Recently my boyfriend has got me into playing Zelda Twilight Princess. It's the only Zelda game I've really played, so that's a lot of fun, and we're gonna play through them all as I finish them and stuff. But recently I haven't had a whole lot of time to play, but yeah, that's kind of like a general idea of some of the games I've played. So question number 7, and this is another one that I really loved and was so excited to answer. If you could be any character in the WoW universe but not Sylvanas, who would you be? So I did think about this for a little bit, and I kind of knew that this would be my answer, but I tried to think, like, is there anyone else who you would rather be? And I was like, no, definitely. I would be Nathanos Blightcaller 100%. Like, even if I had to be, like, a guy, I don't care. It'd be kind of cool to be, like, a female equivalent of Nathanos, but in a way, like, when I was thinking about this question, even if I could choose to be Sylvanas, like, if your question was just, oh, who would you be in all of WoW, including Sylvanas, I don't even know if I'd choose to be her, because half of me is like, yeah, it'd be really cool to be here, but the other half is like, my life and view towards her is more about worshipping her, and that's kind of why I figured like being Nathanos would be like the most awesome thing, because it's like I would always be right by her side, she would completely trust me. Being the champion of the Banshee Queen would be like such an awesome thing, and also just like his role in Battle for Azeroth right now, like leading around like all of like the Horde and everything, it's like I would love to do that so much. The only thing that I may be mildly concerned about if I chose to be him was I've heard some speculation on him maybe betraying Sylvanas, so what the F? But if I were Nathanos, I would not betray her, so yeah, 100% that is who I would be, whether guy or girl version of Nathanos. Question number 8, this is similar to another one that I answered, so it's going to be very, very brief, but I didn't want to skip over any questions. How long have you been a fan of WoW? So like I was mentioning, I've been playing World of Warcraft since mid-vanilla time up to now. I've had breaks on and off here and there, but 100% that game has always been my life and my go-to, and even when I'm taking my breaks, I still think and breathe World of Warcraft all the time. I mean, I'm literally surrounded by it, like in my room and all the merch stuff I have, and like, I'm just, my whole mindset is World of Warcraft, so everything about me has been formed by World of Warcraft for many, many years, so that's, yeah, it's been a long time. So, this question number 9, we are just gonna take a hard turn and stray away from these PG-13 questions and go right into a weird one. So when I asked you guys to ask me questions, I did say you could ask anything, and I kind of was hoping for some weird questions, so thank you for coming through with a weird one. What is your favorite kind of porn to watch? LOL, you said ask anything. Okay, so straight up, I watch girl-on-girl porn, lesbian porn. I'm so sorry if any family is watching this, but I mean, we are all human, and that is definitely my go-to. I just don't like to see other guys' stuff in porn. It just makes me uncomfortable because I have a boyfriend, and it's like, you're not my boyfriend. So yeah, to answer your question, lesbian porn is the go-to. It's good stuff. Number 10, how many times have you colored your hair? I'm not 100% sure on like how many times I've done it because to be honest, even when I just have like purple hair, the amount of times I re-dye it to like several different shades and variations of purple is ridiculous. Like sometimes I'll do it more than twice a week just because it'll be fading and I'm like, you know what, let's refresh this, but let's try a different ratio of hair dye. So if you were to count all of those times, like those individual times where it's just a slightly different shade, probably well over 100 if not more. But in terms of like actual just like colors I have explored, I have had my natural brown, not that I dyed that, but I've had natural brown, black, half blue, half black, all blue, purple, half blue, half purple, kind of pinky peachy colors. I've had red hair. Basically just always end up going back to purple or like blue based purple, more pink based. It's always within the realm of purple. So I don't really know if that even answered your question, but I would say like roughly in terms of colors I've had, probably about 10 maybe. I believe question number 11, I didn't really completely understand it, but I'm still gonna try to answer it. Do you know of anyone or do you need an editor? So I don't know if you're asking me if like I need someone to edit videos for me or something, or if I already have someone to do that, or if you're even referring to YouTube, I don't really know, but I don't need that currently at this stage of my life. I edit all my own videos and post all my own content on all my social media platforms, and I don't really care to have anyone help me with that unless it was like my boyfriend if I like needed that in the future because he's good with that type of stuff. But at this point I'm pretty small. I'm not that popular on YouTube or Instagram, so I don't really require that. If that's what you meant, I'm not really sure. I just didn't want to skip that question. Number 12, what is your reaction to Malfurion's threat to Our Lady Sylvanas? Really do not like that. I used to really love Night Elves. I mean, part of me still does, like they'll always be very beautiful. I'll always play Night Elves and like love like their architecture and all that type of stuff. But in terms of where the lore is going with the whole Horde and Alliance thing, I just absolutely hate the Alliance right now, like so much. If anyone touches Sylvanas or puts her in a bad spot, I'm going to lose my shit. So I was definitely not happy with that, and I really just wanted to tell him to go F himself. F himself? I can't even talk right now, but yeah, I really do not like that. I'm really pissed off at Jaina right now. I just want everyone on the Alliance side to die and to leave Sylvanas alone and just let her turn everyone into the Forsaken. I just want her to kill everyone and raise them as her own people and have all of Azeroth just be Sylvanas's, basically. So yeah, I don't like Malfurion right now. Really don't like Tyrande, even though her new look is kind of cool and stuff. I'm not digging it. And I'm kind of afraid of what is going to happen. And last question, number 13, which was actually asked by my friend Moon, who's at Dark Moon Fair on Instagram. I'll put her name here. And she asks a really awesome question. Why devote yourself to Sylvanas when you literally are her? Instead, you should hashtag bow down to me. This is so true. I really should. I've honestly been referred to as Sylvanas herself by so many people. Like, I've had a lot of conversations with, like, certain fans who also really adore Sylvanas, and they just find my devotion to her and how much like I literally like live and breathe her. I've had a few people be like, you are literally her. Like, Sylvanas does exist in our world because you are her. And that is like the most flattering thing ever. So half of me does want to physically be Sylvanas. The other half is like, I don't want to be her because then I can't worship her, and like my whole like state of being is to worship Sylvanas. So I'm kind of like torn because it's like I wish I could do like both in a way, or I wish I could just be like, I don't even really know how to explain it, but I do still really like that question, and I really think I should maybe start putting hashtag bow down to me. I am Sylvanas, Dark Lady, Banshee Queen for life, all that deal. I pretty much am like in a way covering my whole body with Sylvanas, so in that sense I may be becoming Sylvanas, and labeling myself as the Banshee Queen and the Dark Lady and all that good stuff. So I'm pretty sure I actually missed like two questions. One of them I'm pretty sure I just like forgot to screenshot, but I kind of remembered it, and it was kind of a question like, do you like any bands that are kind of like underrated or something like that? And I did mention this band, but I did want to say I absolutely love the band Ghost Town so much. I feel like they did have like a bit where they were kind of doing pretty well, and I feel like they were getting a lot of like views and stuff like that on YouTube, but I feel like they could be doing so much more, and that their newer music isn't as like out there as I think it should be. So I would highly recommend listening to Ghost Town if you're like a small emo scene girl like me. I'm sure you would like it. Yeah, I'll try to put like a few songs in the description that I would highly recommend checking out. Someone asked, how did you and your boyfriend meet and what was your first date like? So my boyfriend and I met probably a month or so after I broke up with my ex that I lived with in an apartment, which was like the worst, the worst person I have ever been with in my entire life. How I met my boyfriend, basically, I don't really ever hang out with anyone, but there were these two girls that I had like been friends with on Facebook for a long time, and like we had a lot of stuff in common, but we had never hung out before. So we were hanging out and we ended up taking some selfies and posting them on Facebook. But when she posted the selfies and stuff and she tagged me in them, I guess he saw them on her feed, not being friends with me, but it was like, oh damn, who is this girl? And he added me that same night while I was still hanging out with Kathleen and Brittany. And like, I got this friend request from someone named Jamie Brown, and it said one mutual friend with Brittany. And I was like, oh hey Brittany, like, do you know this guy? And in my head I was like, he looks really cute and really emo, I dig that and stuff. And I like had been out of a relationship for a bit, so I was kind of like, ooh, I'm single right now. And she was like, oh, like, I went to high school with him, like, he was pretty cool, like, you can probably add him, he's not a creep. So I added him, and we started talking, like, right then, like, as I was still hanging out with them and stuff, and he was like, it was just kind of casual talk at first, but, like, over a few days, we started talking more and more, and we very clearly were, like, super interested in each other and all that stuff, so it just kind of grew into this thing through Facebook. And at the time, he lived, like, about an hour away, but he was like, oh, like, it just so happens I'm moving back to, like, where you live currently, like, we should hang out and stuff. But I don't really think that we ever had, like, a proper, like, first date or anything, but I know that the first time I met him in person was when he still lived, like, an hour away, and I got my mom to drive me there to meet him, and we, like, went and walked around, like, the town that he lived in, which was, like, smaller than where I lived, and ended up, like, going into a few stores, and this is a little thing that he got me. This was, like, my first little present, and it's just a stupid little, Siamese cat thing that's like fat, and it has been so special to me ever since, because this was the first little thing. I remember just like in the store just being awkward, because I was like, hey, I really like this guy, and like I don't know how to act around new people, and I was like, hey, look at this stupid little cat, and he was like, do you want it? And I was like, no, and he was like, let me buy it for you, and I was like, okay. And now it's kind of been like our special little thing that I've had always, and I keep it near my bed. So moral of the story, I met my boyfriend through Facebook because a mutual friend posted a selfie with me in it and tagged me. And ever since then, things have been so freaking amazing, and he just completely 100% turned my whole world around, especially after being in such a garbage relationship. Like, he is like the first guy who's been like 100% like all the time, like so sweet to me, so caring. He's never ever done anything to hurt me, like, in any way, shape, or form, and like 100% I'm like marrying this guy. He is amazing. So that is the final question for this question video. Thank you so much for everyone who asked me stuff, and really glad that I remembered I left those two out. So thank you guys again so much for watching, and I will talk to you again very, very soon. Bye guys!